One, go.
Okay. Oh, too excited, too excitable. Let's not go to that note. Let's go to the lighter note. Okay. It's a show called Cyrus Says. We have a lovely comedian, one of the best in the business, who's going to join us in 30 seconds. But before that, I want to just quickly suggest to everyone that I've come up with a video, which I will put on air a little later, of how to have a bath in 23 seconds, which is my Bombay Gym World Record. And I think that's going to help a lot of people who realize that they spend too much time in the bathroom. And if they're not pleasuring themselves, it makes no sense why. So I'm going to help you with that. But obviously, the relevant body parts, it won't be vulgar in any way or shape or form. I'll even play some music in the background. You can suggest tracks. So all those in favor, please send me a message as quickly as possible. In the meantime, let's go meet the man who has defined comedy in Gurgaon, that area behind the Triton Hotel and in front of the mall. Especially there, he's king. The one and only Jiveshu Ahluwalia, Dr. Jiveshu Ahluwalia.
डॉक्टर, यस डॉक्टर,
एंड पीछे
मिस्टर
पीछे
जीवेशु,
वो सब जो पढ़ा है ना पीछे, दैट्स ऑल द डिफरेंट डिग्रीज दैट यू गॉट, एम आई राइट? स्कॉटलैंड, एडिनबरा, आई कैन रीड, देन देयर इज अ कपल फ्रॉम गुड़गांव व्हिच आई सस्पेक्ट. गुड़गांव स्कूल ऑफ आर्किटेक्चर एंड मेडिसिन सीम वेरी फेक टू मी, बट एनीवे, वेल डन बेटा, वेल डन. ओके ब्रो, लिसन, इट्स अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग लाइफ, ऑब्वियसली यू नो अबाउट इट मोर देन अस, बट लेट्स डिवाइड इट इनटू टू. फर्स्ट लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द नॉन कॉमेडी एट अ पॉइंट, एंड from what I can read and gather, and correct me please if I'm wrong, which I will be, you went from, and I want to go through all this, door-to-door salesman, movie hall usher, pizza delivery boy, which sounds like really low-brow Gurgaon pawn to me, and then a director at an IT firm, which is like, how do you go from, firstly, that's bizarre, and then we come to the stand-up comedy, obviously, which is your life now. So, Jiveshu, let's go back to, firstly, what were you doing at door-to-door salesman? That was what, college or something?
So, my father passed away when I was four. So,
Oh,
I had financial
sorry,
difficulties. It is what it is. And so, I had to make ends meet. So, I started working out, working in very early.
Four?
No, my
must have sold a lot. Bundi, Bundi, beta, aja, aja, aja. Hey, dekho, ye mere paas hai. I think it's a great sales concept. We didn't think of that, man. Yeah.
You have a child now, you know.
Yeah, that bully, also known as Sorry. So,
started working in very early and started selling biscuits, Dabur Real Gold juice and things like that, and then gradually moved on.
I love Dabur Real Gold juice.
Yeah, I was selling the expired ones.
ठीक है, व्हाट इज एक्सपायर्ड वन? नथिंग हैपेंस. आई बाय ऑल माय प्रोटीन सप्लीमेंट्स ऑल एक्सपायर्ड एंड 25-30% ऑफ एंड नथिंग हैज हैपेंड.
बट यू नो लाइक व्हाई आर यू बाइंग प्रोटीन सप्लीमेंट्स? इट हैज टू शो समवेयर.
दैट्स ट्रू. व्हाट टू डू नाउ? आई जस्ट हैव इट एनीवे.
सो या, सो स्टार्टेड वर्किंग विद ऑड जॉब्स एंड देन मूव्ड ऑन टू पीवीआर, व्हिच वाज द फर्स्ट मल्टीप्लेक्स व्हिच ओपनड अप इन इंडिया.
यस,
एज अ मूवी हॉल अशर.
आई रिमेंबर कवरिंग इट मायसेल्फ एज एन ओल्ड मैन.
या, एंड देन
एज एन अशर.
या या, एंड
द गाय हु गिव्स यू द टिकट.
No, that was my promotion. So I ended up becoming the box office guy for the front row, which is for economically weaker section.
Pehla kya tha?
Torchman. Usher. Usher bada royal naam hai.
Torchman, who puts the light up so you can see the seat. But why this? Was it a well-paying job? You just want to watch movies.
2700 rupees in college.
2700.
2700 in 1997. That was a lot of money.
And in that government, no GST, no VAT, no tax.
No, there was nothing. Like, I had clothes to wear and food to eat. Free popcorn, free Pepsi for life.
Wow. So, yeah. Oh, you have free Pepsi and all that shit?
No. You, I stole.
Jugaad. Not yeah, stole. Yeah, understanding, I suppose.
Yeah, they never understood me. Yeah.
Okay.
So, and then
it shouldn't come back to haunt you later. You do a podcast which nobody but this one PVR employee watches. You know what I mean? That was so disappointing. Yeah.
But then I was caught blacking the tickets. I was selling it for higher prices, the front row. And then I was caught. So I was beaten up and then thrown out. So
wow. Wait. It's slow. You were caught by their management.
Yeah.
Oh shit. You're doing it right. Obviously, you have to do it samne. I mean, matlab.
Nee, wo ghar se police wale utha ke leke gaye the.
That? Oh, they filed a complaint and all that. Proper process.
No, they just told the cop to pick me up, like from my house, and ghar pe wo PVR ki park mein jaake thukai, pitai.
What the hell? And you're supporting the police?
Yeah, I'm supporting the police because they were right.
Offline, we had this conversation where I was anti-police and you're so pro-police. This is ridiculous.
Yeah, I'm very pro-police, yeah.
Your crime was selling in black. It must have been a great film and it was the only right thing to do at that point. Huh.
So, movies were brilliant because people never used to understand the movies and it was the first multiplex, so people used to come and say anything. They used to come and actually sit in air conditioning for 2 hours or 3 hours for 5 rupees. That was the price for the economically weaker section front row. And back then, balcony was about 25 bucks and our third row was 75. So, we were at least three times higher on the pricing point. So, people used to just come and visit as a monument. So people used to come like Anda Conda ki tikte de do, which was Anaconda, Jerry Maguire, which was Jerry Maguire.
Of course.
Babi the Gallant Pig, which is Babe the Gallant Pig.
You do realize this is Delhi Gurgaon. Huh? This is exceptional. Huh?
Yeah.
Jerry Maguire. Maguire.
Maguire. So the worst I've been told is that mujhe 7A ki tikte chahiye. And I had 7A. And I said, 7A karke koi picture nahi hai. He said, sir, 7A hai. I said, nahi hai. So he takes me out of the box. I was like, yeh dekhiye. Wo 7 movie thi, an A certification tha uska.
This guy should do the comedy, yaar. He's better than both of us put together. What a guy.
Exactly.
Observational. Woo, 7A.
So then I got fired, obviously. And then I joined Pizza Hut.
Why do you get fired now? Now you didn't watch out because of the thing. Huh?
Black karta ho, pakda gaya. Then I joined Pizza Hut as a waiter and a delivery boy.
So basically, you're a corrupt man, is what you're telling
us. Yeah,
still corrupt or only then?
I can't be corrupt in comedy. I can't do anything. Like, chutkala nahi sununga, paise le lunga.
Yeah, at least where I come from, you have to give the money back all the time here.
Joined Pizza Hut. And as a waiter and delivery boy for 3 years.
The word is not waiter. What is it called? Pizza... Whatever,
customer service representative
inside the Pizza Hut.
As a waiter, and then I moved on to delivery boy.
So I've done lots of shoots and shows in Gurgaon. So it's very possible that you came and gave us a pizza at some point.
Probably, yeah. And okay. I used to be very nice, so I used to earn from the tips part.
I'm also very nice, no? This is not your typical Sharmaji goes. Oh, dekhiye idhar.
But I was nice to people who used to give me tips. Oh. Or at least be nice so that they can give me tips.
That's why I say you should tip first. I do not understand this tipping end tip thing. End tip thing ka kuch matlab nahi. You must tip first and then the relationship is good.
Also, you should never mess with the waiter or the delivery boy before you order.
Never.
Yeah,
my wife. You can, exactly. No, not just India. That's anywhere in the world.
True. Yeah. And then I was there for 3 years and then I joined an IT firm or call centers back then that was opening up in India as the front office associate or whatever customer service representative. Worked there for 14 years and went on to become the director of the firm.
Oh, so that's why you became the director?
Yes.
So that was a good... I mean, you obviously climbed and did well and all that.
Yeah,
so,
I was there and I was doing good, yeah. So,
so what was your age at this point when you reached the top of the tree and you're the manager of the IT firm?
I became a director at the age of 30.
30? So you're still a young man.
Yeah. And for 5 years, I was doing that.
Okay, so now we have to understand, in the meantime, there was this comedy thing in you.
Yes.
Right? So now you got to explain to us, bro, how you went from, because you've tried all these type of jobs, into almost manual labor, you had horrible experiences. No, but then you got this one job where you've done really well.
Yeah.
So at that point for you to turn is quite odd. I would have thought at the pizza delivery boy, if you turned, it would have made sense. But your stable money, good promotions, in the right line, having, you know, got the equity of so many years.
Yeah.
How, why, what? What happened?
So I think I was always a funny guy. I wasn't looking for doing stand-up comedy per se. And what happens is when you have lack of resources when you're growing up, your defense mechanism is largely either humor or you become a serial killer. Your anger becomes a defense mechanism.
And you tried serial killing and it's just not fun.
I did twice, but then I couldn't become a serial killer.
Every third guy in Gurgaon, yaar. What's the big deal? How do you stand out?
Yeah,
but Rajesh ko dekh, Rajesh ko dekh. Bhai, isme kya hai?
These are both of my people in my house. So I need
Oh shit. Oh crap. Back to the wall.
So defense was my humor. And I was always the funny guy, even in offline life. Like, so there are two types of comics. One is who put up an act on stage and people who are on stage and off stage, the similar personality. I was the quick-witted guy. And people used to call me home.
That's a good observation, actually. There are those who live their part and there are those who put on a persona and then they're really unfriendly sometimes off it.
Yeah.
There's some famous guys like that.
They're not as funny. They're not.
I don't think they're interested in humor, except for when they're performing. Yeah. It's very funny if you try to talk to them. I have a couple of friends like that, huh?
Which I think is a lot of talent. I think to live two lives, I can't figure out.
Just go jaisa, who gives a fuck?
So I was doing one of those things and I was at one of my friend's house cracking up jokes. The only difference was that I used to tell original stories of my life other than people telling...
Actual stories, you mean? Like the beating in the car park and all
that?
Yeah.
So I just put a humorous twist to it and tragedy plus time is comedy, right? So,
yeah.
Anything which is very sad or tragic will put time to it, becomes funny. Like no
Correct.
Funny stories ended in a nice way.
Like now the mutiny can be very funny, but otherwise it'll be a, you know, anti-national thing. But after 200 years, they allow us to make, you know, Mangal Pandey was not that. I'm not saying that.
I'm going to miss you, Cyrus.
Coming to a jail close to you. Huh?
Haryana. And so I was at one of those parties and somebody saw me and they said, ki, you're very funny, why don't you try comedy, stand-up comedy? And there's a comic called Amit Tandon, which is based out of...
Yeah, Bombay, very well known. Huh?
He was based out of Delhi. So him and I used to work together in one of those IT firms together. He was in business development, I was in operations. And he had a restaurant in Gurgaon, where he used to have open mics. That is when I went in for the first day. I came out of the show for 2 minutes. That's a slot you get. And yeah, he came out, he said, you should quit your job, start doing comedy. You made for this. And that was it. Since then, I've been broke and poor. I blame Amit Tandon for it.
Well, what is your story, the two-minute gag? Do you have any idea what the subject?
No. So, yeah. So, my first joke was, hi, my name is Jiveshu. And people call me anything between Jijharu, Jugaru, Jijushu. And
sir, for a Parsi died. In South Bombay, is a tough name. Yeah. I spent 10 minutes going over, so I don't say it wrong here. Jiveshu, yeah. Jiveshu. Aluwale, though, I know. Are you related to Sachin Aluwale, Tito Aluwale? I've got a lot of Aluwale friends, but exactly. No Jiveshu.
And we all related. Yeah, thanks.
I'm sure.
All related.
I'm sure.
Yeah. All Aluwale. There, I'm 19 of
them. Bhai, ek Alu, dusre Alu se ko pata nahi kya farak hai ya nahi.
Exactly. So, so my first joke died, but I enjoyed the experience. And I was telling stories, which is self-deprecating humor. Ki main mota hoon, main chota hoon, main divorced hoon. All that.
Were you divorced?
Yeah. By then I was.
Wow, you really full life, brother.
Yeah. I was divorced.
With or without success, it would be an interesting life. I must congratulate you. Yeah.
So, and I was going through a massive crisis that I got divorced and I was a director in a firm. I could handle employees. I couldn't handle my personal life. I couldn't handle being the best son because my mother wanted me to be married and have a kid. Unlike my younger brother, who is perfect, right? He's the 8-pack. I was overweight, tattooed, appears, smokes, drinks. And he's like, doesn't smoke, doesn't drink, has 2 kids, a boy and a girl, perfect combo, has been married for 15, 16 years. So I was the black.
And stable kid. Job.
He's a senior director with IBM. Yeah.
Senior director with IBM. Wow. Yeah, okay. Yeah. Huh.
So my mother like, maine kya paap kiye the tere ko paida karte hue. So I was the bad son, right? So, and obviously.
And with this kind of motivation from your own mother, how can you go wrong? Yeah.
And that's how my mother motivated.
She's also a bit of stand-up comedy in her. This kind of sarcastic sort of, yeah. Is that there? Is your mom funny?
Oh, she is.
Funny, what's the word actually? Observational funny.
Oh, yeah. Like, so for example, my both domestic helps have been quarantined because they were showing symptoms of cough and cold, right? So I was doing pocha in the morning, mopping and brooming and all. And my mother came and she said, ki, agar karna hai to tamiz se karo, varna mat karo.
What does that mean?
You want to do it properly, otherwise don't do it. I said, ek toh main ghar saaf kar raha hun, out of just courtesy, ki ghar mein koi domestic help nahi hai. And she still treats me like a domestic help. Like, there is no difference. So she is very, very quick-witted. But I think, again, she has gone through so much in life that she has to have a great sense of humor to survive through it.
Okay, sorry. Let's get back to the story.
Yeah, then I quit my job and the first...
This is after one open night. Open mic. Night.
Yeah, first open mic.
Just one.
First open mic. Next day, I quit my job. Without a resignation.
Just Amit Tandon's advice. Nobody else.
Yeah.
What did your mom say?
She said, what the hell is wrong with you?
Ek bar aur.
So for first 3 years, she kept on telling me ki naukri dhoond lo. And she used to call my brother, iske liye naukri dhoond do. And my brother had just moved out of India because of his job. And he called me about a year later. He said, main ek saal hua naukri chode hue tere ko aur tune divorce karwa liya. Naukri chod di. What is wrong with me? What went wrong? What is happening? And then, so I quit my job after first open mic and then struggled for first few years. But the good part was that I had no installments, no loans to
payments,
pay.
And nobody, no parasites, as in children, wife,
no wife,
dog,
no kids,
plant.
Yeah, so I had a dog, but then the good part was that I had no liabilities per se or no expenses to meet, no questions to answer. So my mother's first question when I came in the day I quit my job, she's like, kya khayega? Being a Punjabi mother, I said, Rajma Chawal, and she said, okay.
She's a mother first and a critic second.
And then she stopped talking about me finding a job, I think about 2 years ago, two and a half years ago.
Did she come for any of your shows before you became big?
No, I didn't want her to have seen me on a smaller stage because for a mother, her son is always a superstar, no matter if they're successful.
That's true.
So I wanted her to see me really nice. So I did my biggest show in Siri Fort Auditorium, which I sold out in Delhi. I called her there.
2,000, 3,000 people?
Yeah, about 1,865 people, I called her there.
But by then, you were a known name. Obviously, Siri Fort for you to...
I was okay by then. I think there's still a long way to go. Because
and is a lot of gali galoch in your comedy and all that?
No, I don't because my mother has to watch it. So I do alternates. I do alternate. I would not say BC or MC. I would say kutte ke bacche. सांप के
ओके
बच्चे
ओके
माय अवे
द वेजिटेरियन वर्जन ऑफ द मटन तंगरी कबाब दैट शुड हैव बीन सर्वड
या लाइक सोया चाप और पनीर टिक्का
ठीक है दैट्स एक्सेप्टेबल सो नाउ लेट्स लुक एट द जर्नी एज द कॉमेडियन सो यू हैड नो प्लान यू हैड नो आइडिया योर यंगर ब्रदर इज टॉकिंग टू यू लाइक एन ओल्डर ब्रदर योर मदर इज बीइंग अ मदर बट डीप डाउन मोर वरीड देन शी वाज एंड शी हैज बीन वरीड एवरी सिंगल ईयर यू डोंट नो वेयर दिस इज गोइंग
No.
Because you, nobody knows actually. I mean, when they start with something like comedy.
Yeah,
well, now don't talk big. I have 22 million followers. Apparently, you need to be raided. I'm going to talk to the ICAR department of Maharashtra to send somebody. Delhi and Gurgaon is not, Haryana is not willing to do it. So don't just tell us how does it, I'm sure people listening would love to know, when does a Jiveshu Ahluwalia become a Jiveshu Ahluwalia? When do you, how does that happen? How do you go from just struggling, 10 people in a bar to suddenly 2,000 people? Silvery is coming.
Sorry.
Yeah.
Cyrus, could you just lower your mic a bit? Your levels, you guys, are a little uncomfortable. And Jiveshu, I think your mic got switched. So sorry, guys. I think your mic got switched. Could you please go to Zoom ka settings? Above the mute button, there's a tiny arrow. Just click on that and select your the headphones mic if possible.
And all this is happening live, ladies and gentlemen, only on our
podcast. I mean, it's what are you going to do?
Seasoned comedian, like, arguably top three or four comedians of India. Jiveshu Ahluwalia doesn't know how to fucking hold a mic. Okay? An old man Brocha still doesn't know where to keep this bloody piece. And a 22-year-old from Powai is telling us what to do with a big beard.
Can we talk, Jiveshu?
Yeah, can I? Is it okay now?
You'll hear the hear his hair on his chest rustling.
Yeah,
can you hear it?
Punjabi.
Punjabi, yaar. So is he.
Rishi, is it better now?
No. Just switch to another option.
Rishi is not Punjabi. Sorry. That's the problem. Silvery was okay with it, yaar. Baal to theek hai. Let's go.
Cyrus, also, you'll have to lower your mic a little bit. It's coming a little too loud. Sorry. Yes.
You want me to change the mic? Put another headphone?
Hey, don't show off your Jiveshu. We all know you're doing well.
Please, I have too many of them.
There you go. See? 15, 20 mics, but only one mouth. Look at the irony, yaar.
Yeah, I know.
What a waste.
Let me just try to figure this out. One
second. My daughter is singing Eminem songs.
So
I'm going through a crisis here. I don't know if you guys remember that song called Please Stand Up. She keeps singing it and walking by me to irritate me because she knows I hate rap.
Oh, and you hate standing up also.
I hate standing up and I don't like Eminem. It looks like...
Rishi?
Can you hold the mic?
Closer God, this sounds like K-Pawn, man. Rishi, hold the mic. Please. What's going on, guys? I've got 12-year-olds watching. Only. Maybe less.
Yeah.
But you heard the yeah. The yeah was not a happy yeah. It was like I give up. Yeah.
Can you, is it okay now?
This is how I got married. You know, if you have an arranged marriage, this is how I would get it. It would be like, okay.
So, yeah. Could you please talk another sentence? Jiveshu, I think it's echoing now somehow.
Is it echoing?
No, this is not fine. No, sorry. No. It's robotic. Like
it was so nice the first time. Why did you stop him?
Sorry, it was very low.
Now he's gone back to
the chat also.
Unknown Jiveshu struggling in a bar with a mic with a long wire and you know the battery is gone and it's compromised.
Let me put a stand-up mic if possible. Everyone, stand-up.
And in the background, Mr. Jinjotia is shouting, "Arey wo punch dobara de do banjo." you should write a book about all the badly behaved patrons, man. I love those guys. You know.
So sorry for this, Jiveshu. Guys in the chat, so sorry for this.
No, this is the best part of the podcast. This is the fun part because it's live. I love this. If I was watching, I like to watch television shows where everything goes wrong. Don't you? You know,
yeah,
like the bloopers and stuff.
Love the bloopers, yeah.
Aren't they fun?
Yeah,
they are. Yeah. The BTS and all came out of that and then suddenly it became more fun than the real show. Actually, that's quite a commentary when it's more fun than the real show. Yeah. Okay, now he's like a senior politician.
Oh, now he's...
What for TMC? But in Gurgaon.
Huh. Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Better?
For me, it's always been beautiful.
No, you have to go to Zoom volume. There's a way to check your audio settings. Increase the input volume on Zoom.
I think this is fine.
I think Rishi's standards are very high. He's born and brought up in Czech Republic. So, you know, their sound requirements are different.
Is it clear now?
Yeah.
It was clear then also. We are not winning an award for sound here. I don't know what the problem is.
Rishi.
Rishi.
No, sir, you just turned it up too much now.
He wants you to tone it down.
Tone it down.
For those listening to our live podcast, this is a live sound check going on for the last 10 minutes. This is history.
Better now?
Yeah. Let's just go ahead.
There was more blood in his voice now. That was a good year. I should let's start immediately. I want to get this answer from him. At least one good story, which will hopefully motivate a few people. Because so many people come and ask us. I'm sure they ask you, Jivishu. I want to be comic. I want to be comedian. How do I become famous? So just, this is a difficult question, but I love to know the progression in your mind. Was there a moment? Are there moments? Or is it just over so many period, you know, of time that it happens? I mean, it does. Yeah. But when do you become famous? Like, you know, doing all this.
So a lot of people come and ask me, how do I become famous? How do I become a viral comedian?
That's right.
You don't become a viral comedian or a famous comedian. You become a comedian first.
That's right.
And then it follows. I'm still a long way from wherever a lot of people have reached. And they started much later. There are people who I have surpassed. When does that moment come? I don't know. I don't think so that you click at like some point. Sabne mein Bhagwan aata hai kehta, oh, aaj ki baad tum famous ho. And today's day and age, any video that goes viral can put you on in a spotlight. So you keep writing original material, get up on stage. That's the only two.
The bad part about that is then you're expected to deliver all the time after one who goes viral. So it's a lot of pressure also.
Yeah, true. And you need to write original material, get up on stage every single day. And you're only as good as your last show, only as bad as your last show. So you got to keep doing it every single day, get up on stage.
Okay, but there's a whole list here of countries that you've done shows with. I know lots of our Indian guys are traveling abroad and doing shows. I myself have gone to Dhaka, but then they put me back on the plane because of COVID. but Australia, Bahrain, Singapore, Dubai, Doha, Thailand, Philippines, China, Spain, Italy, Malaysia, to name a few.
Yeah.
So obviously, there's a huge popularity. A guy who's struggling to do an open mic, who's just doing a show on a small pub in Gurgaon or a small gathering of 20 people. And next year, in what are these places? Philippines, Singapore, Bahrain, Dubai, China. China. So how did that happen?
So a lot of corporate shows and a lot of shows that are there. So Indians being second populous country, you have people all around. So I was doing a show in Taipei for the Indian fraternity there. And I do a lot of vernacular comedy, which is largely Hindi or Punjabi or English mixed with it. So Taipei was there, Italy was there, and Spain was there. So you have Indian population there and there. Every time you go and you have a comic who's either Hindi reference points or Punjabi reference points, their recollection back to patriotism kicks in, right?
Desi connect.
Norway, Sweden, yeah. I mean, massive countries, which has a lot of Indian population.
So by now, obviously on the corporate circuit, your name is wanted. People are asking for you. You're charging 15 lakhs just to pick up the phone.
Just make a note of that, 15 lakhs.
Then you got into Bollywood, right?
Yeah, I auditioned for a movie called Tamasha.
Right.
And we shot for, I think, about 7-8 days. But my movie role was chopped off because it couldn't find the space in the edit. So my name was much more prominent from that, the title in the end titles, you know, like featuring Jiveshu to come up on the top of the screen than the whole role in the movie itself.
Wow.
Yeah, it was massive.
And as long as they paid
you. Bhag jayegi, yeah. So that was a 20-25 minute role, which is good.
Okay, so now you actually started acting as well.
Yes, I did. I actually did a lot of ads. Ads happened before movies.
Right.
For Comedy Central.
Philips, Apollo Hospitals, ICICI, Prudential, Grofers, Make My Trip, More. You're just rolling in it. So you've got films, you've got ad films, you've got corporate events abroad, which probably pay you more. Yes. And you've got your shows as well.
Yes.
So you can't complain about lockdown. You've made too much money. You should take a break and let others survive.
Exactly. Also. I'm just digging out my walls and taking out the gold that I've dug in. Like just that's it. Like the buried ones.
Okay. There are two things we've got to quickly jump into before we take a break. Yeah. One is that there's a big weight loss issue where you went from fat to thin.
Yeah. So I used how to weigh about 120, 21 kilos.
Wow.
Now I weigh about 78 kilos. Yeah.
So that's like, I'll smack you around, bro. What is 70?
Yeah, which is like a month's job for you, like losing 44 kilos. Yeah.
So how, why, what?
So I think I was just angry in life, perpetually angry.
As you became successful, you're still fat, right?
Yeah. So a lot of people ask me questions like, are you not taking great care of your health? Would you be funny even when you lose weight?
But wasn't the fatness part of your act also?
Exactly, it was. So I was very scared if I lose weight, I'll not be funny anymore. And I think
Tanmay has to charge less now because he lost about 20 kilos. Apparently.
But he has to be funny too.
Yeah, bastard.
No, he's extremely funny. He's extremely funny.
We have it. We have it on the live. Ah, yeah. Gandu. Mine was a neutral joke. Yours was a vicious one. I like it.
No. So Tanmay.
Don't mess with Gurgaon boys, beta. Gurgaon boys, don't think twice.
So I think when I met Tanmay, Tanmay told me you're the second fat comedian I know who's really funny. I said thank you very much. So it was a good thing to have.
So nice of him to praise me.
Sweet guy. Asked to him, are you a comedian who's fat or you're a fat comedian? And that thing kind of got stuck in my head. And I was just angry. I was angry at people doing better than me. I was just angry at projects not coming in or, you know, one of those.
Because of your weight? Challenges.
Yeah. So I was just angry in life. You're like, koi paisa aa raha hai, wo nahi aaya. Koi project mil raha hai, wo nahi mila.
As you were saying, frustration was generic.
Yeah.
But, okay. Got it.
And I was just angry. And then I just wanted to be angry, but at least good looking. You know, when you go back home and when you sleep at night, if Hrithik Roshan is angry, at least he can look at the 8-pack abs, touch them, feel them, and sleep. I did not even have that option. That was one thing.
What kind of man, when he's wanting to pleasure himself, touches his abs, yaar. Even for a Punjabi, that's a bit too much, yaar. Yeah. 2 inch niche ja raha.
So I just wanted to be, able to take out my anger. And every day I did not go do something about it. I was just generally taking out my frustration on my family and, you know, friends, and I would just snap very, very, very.
So you became the angry comedian.
Yeah, just an angry comedian. Yeah. And a lot of people.
This was not your nature. It doesn't appear to be your nature now either.
Yeah. So
this was like a phase.
A lot of people think that comedian is always funny all 24 hours a day. That doesn't work. Like, that act is 1 hour of my day. I mean, it's like anybody's job. I have a much more life to live.
Fucker, how you all spoiled the market? I gave them 3 minutes. 24 hours, mein 3 minutes. That was my capacity. I don't know why you guys push for 1 hour.
Dude, you made so much money, you know? See, like MTV Bakra and all. You
but I would have continued with the 3 minutes now. I have to work harder because of you all. That bet you... Tanmay.
So blame Tanmay because he came into comedy much before me.
Okay, let's understand the weight loss. So because it can't be easy. A guy who's been fat all his life, the family never pressurized you.
No, they did all the time. All the time. They said, why don't you lose weight? My father passed away when he was 38 because of a heart attack.
Was he a large man?
No, he was a professional wrestler.
Wow, what a waste. Yeah. From a wrestling family and you became a bloody comedian. Now I despise you, yaar. I love sports, man. Comedy can never be there.
No, it can't be. So I had all the genetics to fall ill or probably die. And I smoke, I used to drink. And then I decided to go to gym one day and I had membership of every gym possible, right? I mean, 3 months membership, 6 month membership, yearly membership. And I walked into one of the gyms and I said, I paid in last year for a full month. Can I just join and use that money? And he was kind enough. He said, yeah, why don't you? And I went in every single day from there on. 18th March 2018 is when 18. I
started. So it's recent, yeah.
2019. Yeah. 2019.
And how many months it took to go 44 kilos? Must be a long time.
About 15, 16 months. Yeah.
Is that dangerous to lose so much weight so fast?
No, but I did not diet. I stopped drinking. I stopped sugar, stopped oil and worked out every single day. So, I did not take a cheat day.
Okay.
Every single day. So I went into weightlifting, powerlifting.
Okay. What's your deadlift like?
My deadlift is 170.
170 with the bar. 340. Yeah. That's more than mine. Mine is 352. Yeah. What's your squat?
Squat is 135.
Okay, I'll cram you. I'm 408 pounds. And what's your bench?
That's poor. 60. I think 65, I think. It's just bad.
I'll cram you 375 pounds. But your deads are better than mine. So I respect. But you got genetics of a professional wrestler.
Also, and my body has lifted that much weight for the
first. That's true. And your anger was more than mine.
So yeah. So everybody has asked me, like, what did you do? I said, every time I decided to go to a gym, I hated it. But what I hated more was not going to the gym. So every time I wanted to not go to the gym, I would imagine people that I wanted to hurt.
Isn't this a lovely thing? Once you get into the gym, it's so, you're so obsessive. I can't think of anything else. I just love going to the gym and shadow.
That was my happy part of the day. That was my happy part of the day. Yeah, other than going up on stage. So
okay. That's the fat loss, but which now you're at 70 and you want to stay around there.
I want to go to about 70.
You want to go lighter? You're powerlifting. Why do you want to be lighter?
Because I want to have, my dream is to wear a white shirt and a blue jeans. And when I sit down, I don't want my white shirt to crumble waist below. I want my belly to be in, like, really in.
Well, you can do a close to 400 pound dead and you're, this is what you're, I mean, what the, and you're not even, what a waste. Don't talk to me anymore. You and Tanmay go diet like little girly boys and you do your diets and go cardio and skipping and all this crap. waste my time. Okay, bro, listen, very fascinating story. I want to quickly get in TEDx because your life is... I'm going to ask you a question before you tell us about TEDx. Did you ever think when you were struggling or as a young man, when you didn't know what you were doing or when you were doing those stupid jobs, which, you know, it must frustrate you. Did you ever think you'd become this guy who's going to make so many people happy, travel the world, you know?
Nope,
you ever have a, because many people think, you know, ek din ho jayega, you know, the safalta is there.
Survival,
you know.
In my, I just had a survival instinct. I wanted to put 3 square meals on my
so no clue that you could really make it.
Clue? What are you talking about? No, hell no. Like zero idea. If I could see foresee future, I would be a millionaire by then only. Like, no, there is no way I would have imagined this ever. To have a house or a car or whatever, the comfort.
Wow.
No ways.
One day we'll read your book, but that brings us to TEDx, which is all about you telling your journey, I guess. And
I mean, I think that video got most viral views across anything. I think it's about 9 million views or something.
Wow.
Like that. Yeah. And I think everybody had a story like mine. They just connected to it. Most of the people look at motivational in YouTube videos, which is, I think, pretty sad. That is very lower level of expectations from life. I think you want to look at expectations or inspiration, look around. I mean, every time your mother did not sleep because you were sick or your father did not buy that watch because he had to pay your school fees is the motivation you need, not some random fat guy sitting on a bunch of cash and going up on stage and telling his life story. That is the stupidest thing I could ever think of. But yeah, I mean, when I went into MBA colleges and did my TEDx, it was just funny because I'm a third division graduate. So I'm like 43%. Yeah. Like I couldn't even qualify for buying a form, which is 55%.
It's almost like a veg guy giving a lecture to non-veg guys about food.
Like, haan, padhai karo, dosto. Like smoking a cigarette and telling people, haan, mat piya karo cigarette. Yeah, but it's just one of those things that Josh talks is what, and then I got featured in a book or whatever. So I really liked it. I think that was really nice of them to do it.
No, but I guess it's not right for you to say you'll feel a sense of modesty, but it's great to have a life which went almost from zero to hero, almost like the cliche, because from what you've said, I mean, with your father passing at an early age and life being hard and all that, you look back from there to where you are today, and in between there are other things, almost cathartic things that happened, like your 44 kg loss and you know, you're looking better, sharper, etc. and all that. So I don't know whether it's karma, a little bit of that. Sometimes I wonder, you know.
Now when you look at it, it looks like a tough life. But that, what you have to realize, that when I was living that life, it wasn't a tough life. I had nothing to compare it to. I had nothing. So when I was working as a torchman, that was a job for me. I mean, I can only compare it to a torchman job, which was the best job on earth.
These jobs come into the comedy. I'm sure there must be some anecdotes and all.
Yeah. So those life experiences are built. Obviously, it is there in your DNA. So you keep bringing it up. So I'm very witty. Like, I still remember my earliest joke, the first joke, I think somebody gave me a hand-me-down cap and I was wearing it at night. And somebody told me, ki ye dhoop hai kya? Abhi dhoop hai kya? Then I told him, topi hai, chhatri nahi hai, saale. You know, so I think just quick-witted was one of those defense mechanisms kicking in. So did I imagine this to happen? No, never. Now, when you look at it, it looks like a tough life, but it is a brilliant life. I had nothing to compare it to. I never realized I was poor or I had limited resources. Now, when I sit in a big car, I realize how small that journey was to travel in a bus or walk back from Pizza Hut, about 8 kilometers back home, because I could save money. Like, I would save 2 rupees to walk back. And I used to travel raat ko, bus nahi milega, to auto karna padta hai. Auto, you don't have the money for. If you're earning 2700 rupees, you can't take an auto every day. You pretty much blow your money on autos. Now, when you look back, it looks like a big, massive jump. But back then, no. So you take each day at a time and that's it. I had massive survival skills, a survival instinct, and I still have that.
Yeah, and no shame. Which is very admirable, honestly.
Very materialistic. People ask me, what makes you push? A bigger house, bigger car, bigger phone, bigger watch, expensive. Yeah, I want to, because I never had that in my life.
Say no to lockdown. Capitalism. Jeevan Shu, Zindabad.
Yeah, hamara neta kaisa ho?
Okay, Bhaijaan, we have to take a small break and we'll come back in a minute. It's been a very interesting live. We have AMAs. I think Silvery is an up and coming comedian. I want to ask you some questions as well. As you go into break, what is your turnover last year, beta?
Income tax or post-income tax?
Net, as we see in the Punjab.
I paid off my house.
60 crores?
It's a house, not a mansion, but I like the 60 crores. I will hold on to that.
Positive thinking, brother. We're taking a break. Jiveshu Aluwalia is with us. We'll be back in a second. I may or may not have to do an ad. I'll have to find out. Silvery, what's the news? We have to?
There is an ad. Yeah.
Bro, but I didn't, just this one, right? So, yep. It's the same-ish one every day.
Same one, yeah.
Jivishu, you have to help us with this, huh?
Yeah.
So, it says the Cred Mega Jackpot Week has got me way too excited, at which point you have to show excitement.
Sure.
Both badiya, sir. Both
badiya. That's my acting skill.
That's it. We don't need more. Huh? They cut you out of the first film, Tamasha, remember? From exactly. Three, huh?
Yeah, I know.
From 3 years of free flights to winning a new Tata Safari car. Smile again. Thank you. There are tons of prizes to be won. You can even win free iPhones for the next 10 years, which means my daughter will never make me go shopping again.
Very happy. Now, this is free iPhone for 10 years. Yeah, yeah.
Are you an iPhone guy?
Absolutely. Show off. I will. I'm
of course, capitalism. Comedy doesn't mean you can't be a capitalist. Cred Mega Jackpot Week is from 27th April to 3rd May. New jackpots will be received every day and crazy offers from partner brands on specific days. Soon. Just download.
Cred.
Yes. Well done. You have passed. All right. And we welcome Silvery, who joins us. Silvery, Jivishu is your hero. So you can ask him anything you want. Antariksh, that's a long story.
One quick thing, Saris, you got to lower your mic again. So sorry.
Oh, damn you.
Sorry, man. Jivishu, I want to ask you a ton of things, but one of the main questions I want to ask has already been asked in the chat. So I'll just read the question from the chat. Sure. Mohammad Akib has asked, if not after the first open mic, is there a right time to know when is the right time to quit your job for comedy?
When you make 80% of your salary from your passion, quit your job. Or varna bhooka mar jayega aadmi. Don't quit your job. Yeah, have also, a balance
also,
to do it.
Also, Jiveshu's salary at that time was 2700 or something. So he was aiming lower initially. Yeah. I think if that guy has left IBM for 4 lakhs a month or something, he has to think about it. Huh?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's true. That's right. Okay, let's get to some more questions. We have some great questions from the chat. Yeah. First one is just a comment. It comes from Himani Pandey for Cyrus. She says, "Hi Cyrus, I watched the first episode of LOL of LOL Hansi to Pase this morning. I was laughing watching you put up a straight face." So that's cool.
Oh, it's released?
How much money is he making? No, Cyrus.
Oh, fish, it really? I thought it's really. They're making us do some promo at 4 o'clock live. I thought it releases after that. See, this is the problem. You should pay attention when people talk.
You should pay attention when the money hits your bank.
Remember what Premchand told me once off there.
Premchand?
No, of course not. Aluwal, yeah. You think you're the only guy who talks rubbish? What the fuck, yaar?
Yeah.
All right. Next one comes in from Karan Sethi. He asks, Jiveshu, have you registered for the vaccine yet? And what was your experience like?
Absolutely. I realize IRCTC is a very good website. As compared to Aarogya Setu. Dude, but I did register, yes.
And I registered, but immediately realized that it's been postponed.
You're part of that cancel. See, this is comedy. Yeah. So you registered, you made your mom and dad happy, you did everything correct.
Yeah, exactly.
But I registered because I wanted to.
Government calls and says, sorry, supply nahi hai, baad
mein. Yeah, exactly.
But Gurgaon, Maharashtra Baba hai, struggling, but Gurgaon nahi. Gurgaon mein, there is no cancellation.
No? Because you don't know what vaccine it is it?
Exactly.
But UP,
UP mein they had put rabies.
That lady, the three ladies took it by mistake. You know, we did this story, right, Silvery?
Yeah, it's what's in the
newspaper. Yeah, we did, correct.
Wow, what a story that is, boss, really. I mean, it was just a slightly happier time. It was a little insensitive to go on about it, but it was just ridiculous, man.
Yeah, but I did register. Yeah, it was a great, great experience because IRCTC is so much respect now. 98 OTPs.
98?
Yeah.
Oh.
Have you booked a train ticket ever, Cyrus? Because you're so rich.
Sir, I have traveled by train for a squad.
Traveled? Booked a ticket on IRCTC.
I can't book anything on online or offline. That's a lack of capacity. Not about rich or poor.
Too rich. Yeah, please.
It's just pure. I just let other people do it. Younger people like my daughter.
Sits in South Bombay and makes that. Sure.
No, what? I know Cyrus. Right? He would not be able to do this technologically.
Yeah. I can't even order a vibrator.
It's beyond him.
Yeah.
Yeah, but yeah, the question is, why should you be ordering a vibrator?
But tell me one thing, your deadlift, your staggered grip or hands facing down?
Staggered
grip.
Yeah, right, one left. Of those, yeah.
Okay, so old-fashioned. That's good. So whoever's training you is old-fashioned.
Kuch bhi nikal ke galat batana
hai. I'm more interested in that, yeah. The 374-pound deadlift is not bad for a guy who just started gymming 2 years ago, bro.
Yeah.
And that was an adult, you know. You're not that young with due respect.
So yeah, when you get older, the body recovery is much.
Just your genetics are good for deadlifting.
Probably, yeah.
For whatever reason, your dad.
But I do sumo deadlift, not the traditional one.
You do sumo style, but that's quite tough also.
Because my legs are so wide and so much of thighs.
Your balls don't fall out.
They cut off when I got.
So instructor NHA, na?
Jiveshu about his tattoos and Saris's views on them. Also, big thanks to Jiveshu to always replying on Twitter.
Yeah, I always reply to every social media as much as I can. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
I can't believe you'll be able to talk to every single person who sends you a request and all.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah, social life nahi hai.
Nahi. Lockdown mein where social? What social life? What are you talking about? I have nothing to do.
That's true. Stop reminding us. Well, tattoos, tattoos. What are the tattoos? Yes.
So I have a lot of tattoos. I have my mother's face here on my arm.
Not bad.
Yeah, it's
Oh, sweet. Mama's boy, end of the day, Silvery, just like you. You Punjabis, I tell you, so predictable.
And I've got a, like a mic. Yeah, I've got dogs.
Mic pe mat jaiyo.
Exactly. I've got my dog's face on my legs.
Oh, sweet. Yeah. Plus, we have a lot in common. Dog lover, weights lover, out of work comedians. Everything's working. <That's> great.
Yeah.
We could have hung if I lived in Gurgaon.
Says the person whose Amazon special releases today without telling it.
Bunch of out of work comedians or actors put together in a house. Please understand. Majboori bhi ek cheez hai life mein. Don't talk like this.
I got a lot of tattoos. I got about 17 of them.
I heard a guy in Delhi once, you know, we had gone to this thing. Chinappa was doing some shoot, MTV shoot. And he said, mere ko bhi tattoo chahiye.
Tattoo.
It was a slight accent switch more than like a T-I-T, but it was a tattoo. Instead of tattoo. Just think about it, it is close. Yeah. But we died, yeah. We all died. It was this beautiful moment. This is one of the moments to bring people together, you know. Everybody looks at each other, you want to hug and all that. It's beautiful.
All right. Next one comes in from Kashin Shetty again. Kashin, good morning.
How are Kashin.
Yeah. He says, hello, Jiveshu. Are you aware of the battle between Kake Da Dhaba and Bhappe Da Hotel?
I am aware of it.
Yeah, and as a foodie, which one do you prefer?
Neither. अभी मैं कुछ नहीं खा सकता वहाँ का ना पनीर पसंद है ना बटर चिकन तो बकवास करने की ज़रूरत नहीं है please hang up or please leave whatever you're watching. Neither of those.
Why you don't like chicken?
I can't because I have to lose weight.
So you don't eat any non-veg?
No, I'm not eating butter chicken. Have you been to Bhappe Da Dhaba and Kake Da Dhaba? Please, Bhappe Da.
Just sounds lovely to me.
Yeah, it is CP में है दोस्त क्या खाना है ओए होए होए
मतलब तेल वेल
And Bhappe, yeah. Bhappe is anyways better than Kaka for me. Okay.
So in the end, he's answered it, huh, Sala? Yeah. So one second. You first told me you're only avoiding oil and sugar. Now you're saying you won't eat paneer, you won't eat chicken.
I'm eating. So I can't. So Bhappe mein, matlab kuch grilled chicken nahi milta. Butter chicken
bahut acha. So you are. Okay, I've got it. You got a very. So you're eating, but you're eating a healthy version of everything.
Yeah.
What a waste. Just look at the irony. When you were struggling as a pizza delivery boy and you were hungry, you could not afford all these things.
Yeah.
Now you can afford to eat in any hotel and eat anything and you don't want to eat, you want to grill chicken.
Yes. No.
I mean, what a waste, really. Think about it, boss. This is not funny. This is beyond humor.
I will kill myself after this.
Please do. And take long time over it.
I'll just jump off the first floor like a couple of times. Tell them I don't
know. No, just don't wear a mask.
I just want to tell you a couple of stories. Who's wearing a mask? What is mask?
Gurgaon mein nahi hota.
नहीं हमारे किसी को कुछ नहीं होता
नो ब्यूटीफुल हरियाणा वी आर वेरी टफ यू डोंट वरी
सॉरी या
सॉरी
या
ऑलराइट बाय द वे एनीवन लिसनिंग प्लीज डोंट फाइल अ कंप्लेंट और एनीथिंग लाइक दैट वी जस्ट टू कॉमेडियंस यू नो शूटिंग द ब्रीज देन
नेक्स्ट वन कम्स फ्रॉम करण सेठी ही आस्क्स आउट ऑफ ऑल द कंट्रीज यू हैव विजिटेड व्हिच हैज बीन योर फेवरेट एंड व्हाई
ऑस्ट्रेलिया बिकॉज़ इट इज अमेजिंगली ब्यूटीफुल एंड इट्स सो बिग दैट आई मीन द पॉपुलेशन इज अबाउट 25 crores or 2.25 crore actually.
22 million or something anyway whatever
about high crore log which is population of Delhi
Delhi or Bombay
and in Melbourne one city is 9 times bigger than Delhi so I love people not coming around like I just love that aapko agar ek cup chini chahiye to aapko 3 din rukna padta hai like there is no neighbor the neighbor is about 600 miles away I love that it's beautiful
but they're friendly I've been to Australia once. And it's pretty...
Because they don't see each other every day. You know, they don't breathe in on each other's neck. That's why they're friendly.
I like it. They've got a very homogeneous culture. Everybody's the same.
Yeah. It's like down there. Australia, for sure.
Was there a girl in that story at all?
No. My best friend stay there. I love that guy. I miss him.
Achha, girl's a guy ho gaya.
Yeah.
Only in Gurgaon, Silvery. And he's a heterosexual. Listen to me. He's a heterosexual man. I promise you, I know that. Yeah.
Haan, BB.
BB number one. Two.
Yeah, it is. Yeah, my second marriage, her first
marriage. Better work hard, bro. If you're changing women every 3 years, you want to make sure your career is going the right direction.
And this one is much younger than I am, so she'll probably outlive everything that I've worked for. Yeah. Yeah.
We are proud of you, my boy. One more tattoo from my side.
18 years age gap. It is not easy. Yeah.
Are you serious?
Yeah, yeah.
18 year age gap?
Yeah, yeah.
I'm so frustrated.
Thanks. And she's a psychologist. I'm a third division graduate.
Oh, that's beautiful.
And she's
girl.
Hot. So yeah, I mean, imagine this. Anybody who thought
and I'm she middle-aged. Chased you.
Yeah, and she did. So it's like middle-aged comedian, overweight, divorced, diabetic, comics, out of work, can't get married.
Silvery, a very heavy standard for you to follow now.
Yeah.
Huh?
Wow, man, yeah. One thing, Jiveshu, how many tattoos do you have in total?
17.
17.
How?
Wow.
How old were you when you got your first tattoo?
I think 24, 25.
Okay, so that's old enough. Okay, you weren't like a teenager.
Old enough, but
I can't be because I was too poor to afford a tattoo. What is wrong with you?
Is there a law that you can't do a tattoo?
No, I'm legit asking.
Maa bhooki mari hai, tattoo banwa liya.
I have tattooed the Arogya Setu.
Maa ka tattoo banwa hai na, isliye.
Arogya Setu. Does it work? Like, does it open up?
For safety, I've just kept. Haan ji, main dikhata hai airport pe.
Because if I put it... I don't have anything, but I'm waiting for my OTPs. Let's just...
Okay, next.
Yeah, next one comes in from Tarun Kaushik. Hey, Tarun. He says, do you guys think there is a certain age beyond which one should give up starting life again? Or is it possible to start living a preferred life at any time?
Anytime. Anytime you have money, should start preferred. Yeah, yeah. Like, if today 10 crore rupees come, put the fire in the house and leave.
But this question is a very complex question. Because if you have a family, aging parents, all these other crap, it's not easy to just break the life chain.
Yeah, it is. Because like, for example, I have an old mother. I can't as much as I would want to do a lot of other things. I can't because she stays with me and I would love that any day over anything else.
Correct. So because of that, this truly Indian thing about staying with the parents and the responsibility for the kids and all, unlike abroad, we don't have that second chance.
But so that's why the finances are very important. And as long as you have a good bank balance working towards you, or at least has to survive you through whatever time you would want to pursue your passion or preferred life, it works.
And I have another theory. Like if Jiveshu is doing really well, suddenly, then he's got to realize that he's the guy for the next two generations. He's got to really make money and pretend that nobody else is going to have his success.
And that is also, so first generation earns, second generation spends, third generation earns, fourth. Yeah, it's always that.
Silvery, what about your dad did well?
My dad did all right.
तू तो failure है फिर.
I love how he looked at his house. कहता हाँ ठीक है.
हाँ ठीक है. ठीक है. Condition है, fridge भी है, microwave. Chalo, next, bhai. Next. Yeah,
DBM Drums has a comment. He says, IRCTC is the epitome of OTPs.
Yeah, I know. Dude, there's about 16 OTPs you get before you book a train ticket.
Oh, God, man.
Yeah.
Is that real or you're exaggerating?
About 8 OTPs. Yeah.
8 OTPs. That's a lot, bro. Dude. See, why do they do that? Why is it necessary?
And will so
the not a one-time password anymore.
Yeah, it's not. Yeah, it's like over and over password, yeah.
Okay. Amrita Janardhanan asks.
Janardhan, hey, Bhagwan, yeah, har khatam.
Danan. Janardhan is normal Janardhanan. Name. No, he sings an AN after that. Maybe it's a mistake.
Yeah, just Janardhanan.
Usne galat type kiya hua. Janardhanan.
No, no, don't see that. You'll upset the person. What if it's real? Show respect.
I think it's real. Yeah. There's like a profile picture and everything. It's
Wow, that makes it real, Antariksh. Wow.
Janardhanan, if you're listening, send an OTP. So we know it's true.
Prove it. Prove it.
Amrita Janardhanan asks, do you think nothing is funny enough without pain?
Yeah, I don't think so. No happy story if without a tragic ending is funny. Like, give me a story which has a... Like, main movie dekhne gaya bahut achhi thi. What is the fun part in it? Main movie dekhne gaya bahut achhi thi. Bahar nikal ke meri pitai hui. That's funny.
Yeah. But then why go in?
Yeah, but pitai khane ke liye at least have some enjoyment before that. Now, please, you realize it has to be my life. It has to be beaten up at some point. Physical assault goes with me.
Okay. Akshay K asks, this was Cyrus. Cyrus, why is Cyrus not promoting Kunal Vijayakar's new show, Khane Mein Kya Hai?
Mute.
Cyrus, you went, we lost your audio suddenly.
That's why he's not promoting.
Immediately went on mute. Are time to talk about Kunal's show? Nope.
Still muted.
Sorry, Cyrus, he can't hear you at all.
This is what happens with cheap headsets.
No, it's not that cheap, man. It's a pretty good.
What did you buy it for him?
Yeah, like we bought for him.
Oh, I'm taking it personally.
sorry, we can't hear you at all.
This is probably the most technically challenged video telecast ever.
Yeah, but we also have comments saying that this is the funniest episode of the podcast yet. So thanks for that also.
But can you hear me or not?
Yes,
correct. You're back now.
Okay! I'm back?
Yeah, you're back. You're back.
Oh, thank God, yeah. Okay. It's very embarrassing. I was the host, you see.
And I logged in 15 minutes prior to do audio check.
Wow. 15 minutes of this 51 minutes we've been on have been on audio problems.
Correct.
Which we should not point fingers. Talk about train travel. This is back in the 70s India. Come on.
So Akshay K's question was, why is Saris not promoting Kunal Vijayakar's new show, Khane Mein Kya Hai?
Oh, it's terrible. I can't bear, I couldn't bear it. It's too slow. Like nothing happens. You know, he's just ponderous and walking around. I mean, try to help him. I don't have a beautiful girl.
It's a 3-minute long show. How can it be slow?
No, it's about 6-7 minutes. Yeah. The 3 minutes would have been perfect, I think. But I think if he puts a beautiful girl in it and maybe animals or, you know, somebody dies in the background, those kind of things excite me. Otherwise, you know, it's just a guy lecturing. And after some time, you know, I see him every day. So it's very painful for me. So I will not promote these terrible shows. No, I will not. I will not encourage all this. I'm sorry. Jiveshu, I'll promote your show though. What's your show called?
I have none.
Fine. So as in when you have a show, we will promote it. For now, we'll just call it the Jiveshu special about tattoos. Also known as
the
Jiveshu
show.
That's
Jiveshu
show.
Jiveshu. Yeah. Well done, Silvery. Show. You're on a roll today. Very nice. Upstart.
Yeah. My special will be called That's the Way, My Way.
Ooh, That's the Way, My Way. Excellent. I have no idea what it is, Silvery. I'm just saying excellent to keep him happy.
Okay. Next question comes in from, actually, this is not a question. This is just a comment from Janelle Bain. He says, huge fan of your work, Jiveshu. I've been following your work since you came on the SNG Big Question 4 years back. Love your work.
Thank you so much.
Okay, very cool. Thanks, Jim. Okay, there's another Kunal-related question for Cyrus. He says, Cyrus, how and why did Kunal's show The Foodie get discontinued? Why would Cyrus know all this?
He says, no, I know. He says Arnob and him had a fight. And Arnob, because he was getting more famous and all that. But I heard differently. I heard that he was asking for business class tickets and refused to do the shot again. And, you know, started behaving like Govinda towards the middle of his career. And so I'm not sure because I think they're very similar personalities, Arnob and Kunal. So quite frankly speaking. But it got discontinued very quickly. And there was some drama between them. I know that because there was a shouting match, et cetera, et cetera. And that was the first time we realized Arnob is not what we thought he was. You know, because he appeared very...
Soft-spoken guy.
He was. When we met him, I did a couple of his shows on Time Now for cricket and this and that. And he was very soft-spoken. And in fact, he's like, you know, he's like the cop. He's like how Silvery is with seniors. You know, he'll be like, kaise ho, sab theek, you're good, great, we're big fan. You know, all that overacting which you Punjabis do so well. And then suddenly, the switch happened on camera. And the people...
Two type of comics.
Yeah, one type of comics. And he is a comic. That I give you that. Well put. So they discontinued. There's some drama there. One day we'll find out the full truth between what happened, why it was discontinued. Maybe it was just...
Sorry. Go ahead.
Maybe he was just too fat. There might have been government regulation. You lost 44 kilos. He hasn't. He put on weight. Went to 107 in this lockdown.
Wow.
Ab to 2-3 kilo niche ho gaya. Let's see what happens.
The good part of being overweight is that you can lose weight anytime. That's a good part.
Or you can go even more up.
Sorry.
Next one comes in from the plant-based foodie. Says, I was one of the front row PVR ticket bunking class from LSR. Nothing like the $7 tickets when you have money.
Lady Shiram. Or a campus man.
I'm sure. So this is, the 5 rupees, 7 rupees ticket. Exactly. That's what I was in charge of for about a year. And then I did what I did and got beaten up and thrown out. So I know what it feels.
The PVR ever call you back to do a show for them?
Yeah. I did.
For PVR?
Yeah.
But they know.
Tick-tick Black is different. No, that was necessity. This is my profession, obviously. Yeah. I did 2 shows for PVR.
Not bad. So all is forgiven. It comes a full circle in a sense.
Or probably the manager died. I don't know. Maybe he doesn't remember.
Oh, nahi hoga. Yeah. Or maybe he got picked up for black marketing 2 years later.
Maybe. Yeah.
right. Hello, Silvi, last one.
Yeah, last one comes in from Kashin Shetty again. He says, as a fellow fat person, I relate to Jiveshu's anger. Is there anything from your youth which angers you till today? And please don't say traffic in Parel.
VIP culture.
I was never in Parel. I was never in Parel, so I can't. And Bombay people have bad traffic, but you have smaller roads also, so I pity you guys. For youth, I think when you're fat, you lose a lot of opportunities. You have very bad luck or poor luck in terms of opposite sex, girlfriends, your friends. Same sex mein pata nahi chalta na India mein. Haath pakad ke hum ghumte rehte sari zindagi mein pata hi nahi chalta. So yeah, so I think lack of opportunities, people look down upon you, lack of buying clothing options and crap like that. So it does play on your emotions and it does play on your insecurities. Yeah, it does. So I think anger is built up over a period of time, and that is when you become either a comedian or a serial killer. And I've tried serial killing, couldn't come up after my counting for two.
Although with comedy, you can kill more people.
Yeah, I can.
I've seen some bad comics, I have to tell you.
Yeah. But kill in comedy terms is doing
well. Sorry. You guys are different. Bomb is bad. My generation, kill was actually meaning kill and all that. Now, yeah.
My generation, you're like 3 years younger.
So bomb is bad, kill is okay. Got it. What about shoot? My comedy shot today, yaar. What does that mean?
That you're making money for Amazon special for 98.
I'm not making any money, brother. I'm doing PR and I have tech problems and nothing is being uploaded onto a Mac, which I don't have. And you have no idea what my life is like, beta. I am being molested by technology. Molested every day. I'm just being wrapped, I say.
You have three people running your technology thing.
What,
yeah,
three people? They're mother, daughter and Holy Ghost. Who's there?
The people who are on the Zoom call.
No.
Sir, audio ठीक नहीं है आपका sir.
वो Rishi, वो podcast के लिए है यार. Podcast मेरा नहीं है. The Silvery is the guy who owns the podcast.
And no, gets money.
What?
Cred money.
All the money in Mumbai is in Powai, where he is.
Yeah.
What is Malabar is all big talk, yaar. We have no money, no liquid cash, just hanging on to our flats.
What is his last name? Hiranandani.
हाँ.
अच्छा फिर ठीक है.
The शक्कर से मिलती है देख.
Correct. Yeah. Exactly. Yeah. अंतरिक्ष शक्कर हिरानंदानी.
Third cousin from the right. Very famous.
Yeah.
Okay, guys, I have to pull out, to use a phrase which ended after the Suhagrat. But what a great honor, Jiveshu. Really lots of love to you, and I hope you do really well. What a great story. What an inspiration. Salute, as we say in the Punjab. Okay, Silvery, I'll see you soon. Bye-bye. Bye, guys.
Bye-bye.